It's Monday afternoon. What's the current status of the fire?
The fire is about 4,000 acres. Most of the activity is really kind of in the northeasterly section, kind of away from Lower Lake right now, burning right up to the edge of where the Rocky Fire burned last year. We're really trying to get a good box around this fire, hold it into this area, and then make sure that any hot spots that do occur within the fire, but especially in the burned areas in Lower Lake, that we quickly extinguish those. We want to make sure that there's no potential for flare-ups. There's no potential for this fire to get out of control. And as I mentioned, our number one priority will continue to be making sure people are safe. Residents need to be safe. Our firefighters need to be safe. Safety is always key here.
If you could just tell us what to expect as we return to Lower Lake.
Right now, we're continuing to monitor for hotspots throughout Lower Lake. While the fire is not as active as it was yesterday, we want to keep it that way. But there's still a lot of hazards. We still have a lot of potential for this fire to change again directions like it did yesterday afternoon and come into Lower Lake and even maybe even into the southern portion of Clear Lake. That's why those evacuations still remain in effect. Yes, it may be blue sky over much of downtown Lower Lake, but there's still a lot of hazards that need to be cleaned up. Power lines that are down, trees that are down. All those hazards have to be mitigated before we can get residents back in. But our number one priority is to get residents back into their homes. And for those that unfortunately their homes were destroyed, for that rebuilding and that healing process to begin. And what happened last night is so difficult for us because we worked so hard last year to keep this community safe, just like the other communities all the way around it. But unfortunately last night, Mother Nature had the upper hand on us.
Can you describe some of the historic areas that survived, please?
Several of the museums around here are still standing. Much of the downtown section is still standing. And when you get into some of the neighborhoods, it's very sporadic. This home burned, but this one didn't. And a lot of that comes down to sometimes simple luck. Where are the embers going to rain down on? And then what type of materials is that home built out of or that structure built out? If it's got a wood-shake roof, it's going to burn much easier than a home that's got a metal or even other types of composite roofing or enclosed eaves. Those are critical things that a home has to be built out of to really withstand when it's an ember rained type of fire situation like this was.
If I'm a local survivor of this fire, what should I be doing now and when should I most reasonably hope to be able to return home?
You know, many people chose not to evacuate immediately. They really, because they've been through so many fires throughout the years and survived it. Even last year, Rocky, Jerusalem, Valley. But we saw just how quickly this fire changed in directions. And that's why it's critical that residents leave early, evacuate early, not only for the safety of residents, but for our safety. Situations like last night, our number one priority is going to be just getting people out. Human life will always be our number one priority, but that means our firefighters have to come off their mission of fighting the fire and actually try to help get those residents and those people to safety. So if you're not evacuated, be on high alert. Be prepared because these fires, just like last year, are burning so erratically and intensely that there's not going to be a lot of time, a lot of warning. Now, for residents throughout the rest of Lake County, not directly impacted by this fire, you too should be ready. It only takes one spark, and we've seen how quickly these fires are able to grow. Have that evacuation plan. Be ready to and ready to go so when a wildfire is in your area, you can evacuate early. Today and yesterday have been very difficult days for Lake County as a whole. And we are so thankful for those residents who evacuated early. We are so thankful for those who heeded the warnings. And just know how difficult yesterday was. This was a challenging firefight, and this fight is not over. And we will be here in Lake County until this fire is completely extinguished, until it's safe to get residents back into their homes. And we want to get everyone back as soon as possible.